गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. वॉइस इनपड़ती अंदर, इट इज ऑडिबल. हेलो. ओके. Last class we discussed about the problems in the spicing techniques and some of the problems across the connectors. Okay, problems chepkunam last class lo. Today also I was discussing some problems on dispersion losses and related pulse broadening. Okay. Okay, these are the formulas that will be used for the intermodal dispersion, intramodal dispersion, and also waveguide material dispersion and some of the pulse broadening dispersions. Okay. Here I was taken some material dispersion problem. సెకండ్ యూనిట్ లో మన ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఏం డిస్కస్ చేయలేదు, అందుకని ఈరోజు ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ చెప్పుకుందాం. రేపు ఫోర్త్ యూనిట్ స్టార్ట్ చేద్దాం. ఓకేనా? అండ్ కమింగ్ టు ద పల్స్ బ్రాడ్నింగ్, మెటీరియల్ డిస్పర్షన్ అండ్ ఇంటర్ మోడల్ డిస్పర్షన్ అండ్ వేవ్ గైడ్ డిస్పర్షన్, బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దిస్ విల్ బి డిస్కస్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. ఓకే, కమింగ్ టు దిస్, some glass fiber exhibits the material dispersion is given by delta square d square n1 by d delta square is equal to 0.032 for a wavelength 0.9 micrometers. A particular wavelength dagra manaki material dispersion anedi 0.0325 anedi execute avutundani cheppam. Find the material dispersion parameter and pulse broadening per kilometer for a good LED source with RMS spectrum width is 25 n meters. Okay, spectrum width icharu at a given wavelength 0.90. Okay, so here they given the spectrum width and wavelength, and they will be also be given some of the dispersion. Material dispersion will be given. You want to find out the parameter of material dispersion parameter and pulse broadening per kilometer. Okay, I don't know what to call it. Okay, so given data, so here the given data, which is represented as operating wavelength, will be given, and RMS spectrum width will be given. And material dispersion parameter is equal to, so material dispersion parameter is equal to del by c d square n1 by d delta square. So manaki ikkada manaku already ichina question lo delta square d square n1 by d delta square ani ichcharu. So manam dani simplification teeskunte 1 by c lambda into 1 by into lambda square into d square n1 by d lambda square. So a formula manaku substitute chesthe c value manaku telusu, velocity of light, so velocity of light is 3 into 10 power 5 and lambda vachesaru wavelength, so manaku vachesariki 0.9 micrometers anedi ikkada wavelength anedi teeskunnam. And paina edaithe delta square d square n1 by d delta square n1 of r no ikkada substitute chesam so material dispersion is equal to 120.3 ps by n meters kilometers okay so rms pulse broadening due to material dispersion will be given as rms pulse broadening due to material dispersion is given by so मन फार्मूला वेसर की सिग्मा मेटीरियल इज इक्वल टू डी मेटीरियल ऑफ डेल्टा इंटू एल इंटू सिग्मा लैम्डा सो मन इकोर फार्मूला फर् किलोमीटर अनेकटी वट एवर द रिप्रेजेंटेशन दट विल बी टेकन इनटू द काउंट सो डी मेटीरियल फर् वन किलोमीटर इज इक्वल टू 25 इंटू वन Into 102.37 into 10 power minus 12. But clear ga ichadu spectrum width is equal to 25 nanometers. So 25 nanometers ane daga representation ane teesukunam. Manaku d material ane value telusu kabatti aa value ni direct ga substitute chesam. Okay na? Length is equal to 1 kilometers. Kabatti 1 anedi ikkada consideration teesukunam. So d material is equal to 2.55 nanoseconds per kilometer anedi ikkada manam teesukuntunnam okay na manaki material dispersion gaani waveguide dispersion gaani हेलो मटेरियल डिस्पर्शन प्रॉब्लम्स ओके ना सिमिलरली अनदर क्वेश्चन विच इज रिलेटेड टू द मटेरियल डिस्पर्शन पल्स ब्रॉडनिंग ओके सो दे गिवन द मल्टी स्टेप इंडेक्स फाइबर रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज 1% एंड कोर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज 1.46 एंड द मैक्सिमम ऑप्टिमम विड्थ दैट विल बी ऑब्टेन्ड विद ए पर्टिकुलर सोर्स on 4.5 kilometers link is 3.1 megahertz okay so they've given some optical link which is a 4.5 kilometers with a 3.4 megahertz frequency will be considered okay determine the rms pulse broadening per kilometer resulting from intramodal dispersion mechanism okay intramodal dispersion mechanism nunchi rms pulse broadening value anedi per kilometer identify cheyali assuming waveguide dispersion may be ignored okay waveguide dispersion will be ignored here estimate the rms spectrum width of the source used the material dispersion parameter for the fiber at the operating wavelength is 90 ps by nanometer kilometer okay nm kilometers and here given data delta ichadu relative refractive index ante delta So delta is equal to 1%. That means 0.01%. And core refractive index is n1 1.46. Maximum optimum bandwidth. Clear picture. Maximum optimum bandwidth. So bandwidth is always represented as BT is equal to 3.1 megahertz. BT is equal to 3.1 megahertz. So you can find out the spectrum width of the RMS pulse broadening per kilometer. At the same time, you can find out the material dispersion for a fiber at a operating wavelength 90 ps. Okay, so first you already know the bandwidth length product approximately for Gaussian shaped, which is represented as BTL is equal to 0.2 into sigma.
Hey, bite kira.
Sigma t.
Bite ko chesey.
Vastar lera. And here we already know the BT value, we already know the L value. L value is given as 4.5 link kilometer for link, and BT value is bandwidth length product. So you can substitute that value, you can find out the spectrum width. Okay, sigma t is equal to 0.2 by 3.1 into 4.5 into 10 power 9. So finally we can obtain that sigma t is equal to 0.014 ns. Okay, and next one, they will given the material dispersion is equal to ns/nm. Okay, 90 ns per nm kilometer, neglecting waveguide. So my total dispersion which is RMS pulse plotting low. So we have sigma t is equal to sigma material, that is nearly equal to sigma lambda d material of L into L. So my dispersion material dispersion anedi ikkada teeskuntunnam, waveguide dispersion anedi eliminate chestunnam kabatti total dispersion is equal to material dispersion avutundi. So manu material dispersion formula vachesarki sigma lambda d material into L. So manu kavalutundi sigma lambda anedi identify cheyali. Okay, na wavelength anedi akkada particular ga manaki kavalu kabatti aa formula matika akkada represent chestunnam. So finally we can obtain the sigma lambda is equal to nearly equal to 3.4 m nanometers. So manaki spectrum width vachesarki endante ikkada ee formula ni base chesukoni manaki representation anedi teeskuntam. Question lo clear ga istharu, question lo manaki ichetappude so waveguide dispersion is eliminated. So total dispersion vachesarki manaki that is equal to the material dispersion. So material dispersion formula manaki anni chotla maradu eppudu. So material dispersion is equal to sigma lambda into d material of lambda into L. So d material of lambda ane 90 ane ichadu. So manu direct ga substitute cheyali. Okay, and this ee type of problems anedi manaki ekkuva vastayi. Alane manaku vache sariki next problem vache sariki multimode step index fiber with a core refractive index 1.5 and the relative refractive index is 1%. And a delta ichadu. Alane manaku vache sariki refractive index n1 ane value ichadu. Refractive index n1 value anedi ikkada ichadu. Okay na, alane manaku vache sariki endante the delay difference between the slowest and fastest modes anedi identify cheyali. Alane RMS pulse plotting due to intermodal dispersion anedi find out cheyali. At the same time you want to find out the maximum bit rate. Okay, maximum bit rate anedi identify cheyali. Alane you want to find out the bandwidth length product. Bandwidth length ante BT ane value anedi kuda find out cheyali. Mottham naalugu values ni ikkada find out cheyali. Or in two way, only refractive index ichadu, alane relative refractive index okati ichadu. Okay na, so given data n1 is equal to 1.5 and refractive index delta is equal to 1%. So first one is delay difference. So delay difference is equal to dou ts. Step index fiber తీసుకున్నారు కాబట్టి dou t suffix si. So that is equal to l into n1 into delta by c. n1 value తెలుసు, delta value తెలుసు, c value తెలుసు. అలానే లెంత్ l 6 కిలోమీటర్స్ ఆప్టికల్ లింక్ అని క్లియర్ గా ఇచ్చారు. So length l is equal to 6 కిలోమీటర్స్. So 6 into 10 power 3 into 1.5 into 1%, 0.01 by c velocity of light, 3 into 10 power 8. So we can obtain the delay difference dou t is equal to 300 nanoseconds. 300 nanoseconds. And second one, you want to find out the RMS pulse broadening due to intermodal dispersion. So here sigma si is equal to L n1 delta by 2 root 3 c. So all the values will be identified. So you can substitute the 300 ns by 2 into root 3 value. So that is obtained as 86.6 nanoseconds. The RMS pulse broadening due to the intermodal dispersion is 86.6 nanoseconds. And the maximum bit rate, BT, is equal to 1 by 2 tau. So that is equal to tau and delta TSI. So 1 by 2 tau TS is equal to 1 by 2 into 300 nanoseconds. That is 1.7 megabits per second. Megabits per second. That is the maximum bit rate for the for transmission. Okay. The bandwidth length product. So BT maximum into L is equal to 1.7 into 6. So that is equal to 10.2 megahertz kilometers. Bandwidth length product. So bandwidth manaku telusu maximum bit rate anedi 1.7. Length వచ్చేసరికి kilometers, 6 kilometers. So finally, bandwidth product length is equal to 10.2 megahertz. Okay. Alagane adagochu question anedi. Okay. Now, next one, we have multimode optical optimum near parabolic gradient index fiber. If you consider the parabolic gradient index fiber as a material dispersion parameter, 30 PS NM. Kilometers, okay, nm kilometers. That is the material dispersion parameter. Okay, and when we are using the good LED source, the RMS spectrum sigma, okay, 25 nm. RMS spectrum is chadagada, sigma lambda is equal to 25 nanometers. The fiber has numerical aperture 0.4, so na is equal to 0.4. A core axis refractive index is 1.48. And cladding is 1.47. N1 is equal to 1.48 and 2 is equal to 1.78. Estimate the total RMS pulse broadening per kilometer within fiber assuming waveguide dispersion is negligible. So estimate the bandwidth length product for the fiber. Calculation, they want to find out the RMS pulse broadening per kilometer. Here the waveguide dispersion is negligible, and also find out the bandwidth length product for the fiber. So the given data will be estimated here. Given data, material dispersion d material lambda will be given, and spectrum with 25 nanometers, numerical aperture, and n1 n2 they will be given. So you want to find out first material dispersion per kilometer is equal to d material of lambda into L into sigma lambda. So d material ante 30 vachesindi, and length vachesariki 1 kilometer, and sigma lambda spectrum width vachesariki 25. So we can calculate that we can obtain the 750 PS per kilometer. So we want to find out the RMS pulse broadening due to the intermodal dispersion in the gradient index fiber is given as, here clearly initiated that gradient index fiber. So single index fiber, the formula will be changed, 2 root 3 vastundi. Along gradient index fiber ko chesariki 20 root 3 anedi ikkada meeku add avutundi. That is the difference of the gradient and single fold. So sigma gradient index is equal to L into N1 into delta square by 20 root 3 C. 20 root 3 C. So you can simplify, the L value will be known, N1 value will be known, and delta value also be known, and C is the normal representation, okay, velocity of light. So you can substitute the all the values, will be obtained the sigma gradient index fiber is equal to 14.24 PS per kilometer. So we want to find out the RMS pulse broadening. So sigma T is equal to square root of 750 square plus 14.24 sigma square. Okay, that is the sigma RMS pulse broadening value is be considered, because here you will be calculate the sigma T is equal to square root of we have formula, sigma T is equal to square root of sigma intra square plus sigma inter square. So here dispersion waveguide dispersion will be eliminated. So automatically 750 square plus 14.24 square will be considered here. So sigma t is equal to 750.13 PS per kilometer will be obtained. PS per kilometer will be obtained. That is the question that will be initiated. అంత పెద్దగా ఉన్నా కూడా మనకు కావాల్సింది ఏంటంటే సిగ్మా వాల్యూ మెటీరియల్ అనేది కావాలి, అలానే ఆర్ఎంఎస్ పల్స్ బ్రాడ్నింగ్ వాల్యూ అనేది ఐడెంటిఫై చేసుకుంటాం. ఓకేనా? అండ్ సెకండ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ రిప్రజెంటేషన్ విచ్ ఇస్ సిమిలర్ అండ్ హియర్ ద టిపికల్ సింగిల్ మోడ్ ఫైబర్ హ్యాస్ ఏ జీరో డిస్పర్షన్ వేవ్ లెంత్. ఓకే, జీరో డిస్పర్షన్ వేవ్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ 1.31 మైక్రోమీటర్స్ with dispersion slope 0.09 PS will be given. So compare the total first order dispersion for the fiber with a wavelength 1.28 and 1.55 micrometers. When the material dispersion and profit dispersion at the later 13.5 PS and 14.4.0 PS. Okay, they will be comparing the some representation of the dispersion. మనకి డిస్పర్షన్ ఆర్డర్స్ అనేది ఎలా ఉంది అనేది కంపారిజన్ అనేది ఇస్తున్నారు అక్కడ. ఓకేనా? అండ్ ఆల్సో డిటర్మైన్ ది వేవ్ గైడ్ డిస్పర్షన్ అట్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ వేవ్ లెంత్ సో ద గివెన్ డేటా విచ్ ఈస్ గివెన్ యాజ్ జీరో డిస్పర్షన్ వేవ్ లెంత్ లాంబ్డా నాట్ 1.31 మైక్రోమీటర్స్ సో 1310 నానోమీటర్స్ గా ఇస్తున్నారు. And material dispersion is 13.5 and dispersion 0.4 PS and dispersion slope is not is equal to 0.09. So we have the formula total first order dispersion for the fiber at wavelength 1.28 is given as d into it's not one lambda not by lambda whole power 4. That is the formula for first order dispersion. According to total first order dispersion then what is the formula means dt at a particular wavelength is equal to lambda s not by 4 into 1 minus lambda naught by lambda whole power 4. Okay, that is the formula. You already know the lambda value. What is the wavelength? 1280 and S naught slope. So 0.09 into 10 power minus 12 by 4 into 1 minus 1310 by 1280. So you can simplify the expression. You can obtain the minus 2.8 PS nanometers per kilometer will be obtained. That is the DT value. And DT across the 1550 nanometers. 1.55 దగ్గర కనుక్కోమన్నారు. So 1550 nanometers దగ్గర ఎలా ఉంటుంది? Same formula. Then you can substitute that value. Then we can obtain that 17.1 PS nanometer kilometer. So we already know that formula. The total DT is equal to dw plus dm plus dp. సో మనకు కావాల్సింది ఏంటంటే వేవ్ లెన్ డిస్పర్షన్. సో వేవ్ లెన్ డిస్పర్షన్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు డిటి మైనస్ డిఎం ప్లస్ డిపి ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 17.1 మైనస్ 13.5 0.4. ఫైనలీ వేవ్ గైడ్ డిస్పర్షన్ డిడబ్ల్యూ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 3.2 పిఎస్ నానోమీటర్స్ కిలోమీటర్స్ హోల్ పవర్ మైనస్ 1. ఓకే, దట్ ఈస్ ద రిప్రజెంటేషన్ విల్ బి అప్టైన్ from this type of formula. Okay, and multimode gradient index fibers exhibits the pulse broadening 0.2 micrometers over a distance of 15 kilometers then find out the optimum bandwidth of the fiber dispersion for unit length and bandwidth length product. So they given the data total pulse broadening tau is equal to 0.2 microseconds. Okay, and distance is L is equal to 15 kilometers. So first one, optimum bandwidth, that means BT is equal to 2 tau. So 1 by 2 tau kabatti, then that is equal to tau value is 0.2 microseconds. So that will be substituted here, then BT value will be obtained as BT is equal to 2.5 megahertz. The dispersion for unit length may be acquired by dividing the total dispersion by the total length of the fiber. So dispersion for unit length which is key, total dispersion by total length of the fiber. So tau by L. So there is formula. So 0.2 into 10 power minus 6 by 15. So dispersion for unit length is equal to 13.33 nanoseconds per kilometer. That is the formula for dispersion for unit length is equal to total dispersion by length of the fiber. Okay, so tau by capital L is the formula. And the next third one, bandwidth length product. We already know the bandwidth length product, BT into L. So BT value is 2.5 and length is 15 kilometers. So 2.5 into 10 power 6 into 15. So bandwidth length product is equal to 37.5 megahertz per kilometer. And alternative length product, manaki inko formula undi, bandwidth for length vachesariki, that is BT into L is equal to 1 by 2 into dispersion for unit length. Dispersion for unit length. There is another formula which is related to the BT into L. So manaki dispersion for length aniste okko sari manaki length ivvakunda dispersion for length anedi isthe ee vidhanga kanukovachu. 2 into 13.33 into 10 power minus 10 isthe directly you can calculate the bandwidth for length product. And another type of model which is considered as single mode fiber operating at the wavelength of 1.3 micrometers is fine to have a total material dispersion 2.8 nanoseconds and total waveguide dispersion 0.495. So manaki ikkada wavelength ichadu, material dispersion ichadu, waveguide dispersion ichadu. You want to find out the determine the receiver pulse width and approximate bit rate. Transmitted pulse width is 0.5 nanosecond. Here again data equal to 0.495 nanometer, and lambda is equal to 1.5 meters, and T naught. They will given the some transmitted pulse is equal to 5 nanoseconds. Okay, is equal to T naught is equal to 3.53 nanoseconds. So that is considered as a pulse 3.5 nanoseconds will be RMS pulse width of the sigma naught. So you want to find out the total dispersion. So total dispersion is equal to T material plus T wavelength. So D is equal to 3.305 nanoseconds plane. And beta 2, probably beta 2 is equal to minus D lambda square by 2 pi C. Beta 2.25 into power yes, the value will be obtained. So we already know the formula which is related to the sigma D is equal to D into L into sigma lambda. So D value we already know 3.305 into 10 power minus 9. L is 1 kilometer, so 1 will be here representation, and sigma lambda is equal to 1.3 into square root 2 into 10 power minus 6. That is the formula. So we can obtain that sigma D is equal to 3.035 into 10 power minus 12. So total output pulse width sigma is equal to sigma naught square plus sigma d square whole power 1/2. So manaku rendu values identify unnai. So you can substitute that values. You can obtain the output pulse is equal to sigma is equal to 3.535 into 10 power minus 9 seconds. So broadening factor, which is considered as a sigma by sigma naught. So you can substitute that values. You can obtain the pulse time period is equal to 4.99 nanoseconds. So bit rate is equal to RB is equal to 1/2 tau. So 1/2 tau kaapatti, then 1/2 into 4.99 into 10 power minus 9. So RB bit rate is equal to 100 megahertz for the optical signal. Okay. ఇలా డిఫరెంట్ గా ఉంటుంది ఈ మోడల్. ఓకేనా? అనదర్ మోడల్ విచ్ ఇస్ రిలేటెడ్ టు ద ఆర్ఎంఎస్ పల్స్ విత్ స్పెక్ట్రమ్ విత్. సో ఫర్ ద ఫైబర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ గివెన్ దట్ లాంబ్డా ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 850 నానోమీటర్స్ అండ్ లాంబ్డా స్క్వేర్ డి స్క్వేర్ n1 బై డి లాంబ్డా స్క్వేర్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 0.015 అండ్ ద ఆర్ఎంఎస్ పల్స్ విత్ ఆఫ్ ది లైట్ సోర్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 20 నానోమీటర్స్ at this wavelength determine the material dispersion parameter RMS pulse broadening due to the material dispersion. So operating wavelength lambda is equal to 850 into 10 power minus 9 meters. So you can you can write the given data operating wavelength lambda and the dispersion related for now 0.015 and spectrum width. So material dispersion is equal to lambda by c into d square n1 by d lambda square. So lambda manu initiate chesthe 1 by c lambda into lambda square d square n1 by d lambda square. So manu substitute chestha value ni d material is equal to 58.8 ps nm kilometer anedi for vastundi. Okay na? So d material anedi direct formula dwara manu kanukuntam ikkada. RMS pulse broadening. So D material nearly equal to the sigma lambda into D by C lambda into D square N1 by D lambda square. So ee formula ni mana simplify chaste sigma lambda into D material of lambda into D. So RMS per kilometer is equal to sigma D material of lambda. So 20 anedi mana spectrum width ane icharu. So 20 into D material, dispersion material, 58.8 into 10 power minus 12. So finally, we can obtain the RMS pulse broadening per kilometer is equal to 1.17 nanoseconds per kilometer. This is the pulse broadening. Okay. Sorry. And second simple formula. Single mode step index fiber is given. Total pulse broadening is 95 nanoseconds over 5 kilometers length. Okay, estimate the bandwidth length product for the fiber for a non return to zero digital signal is used. So here total pulse broadening tau value will be given. So tau is equal to 95 nanoseconds, length is equal to 5 kilometers. So we have the formula bt is equal to 1/2 tau. So 1/2 tau anedi manu akkada substitute chesthe then bandwidth is equal to 5.5 megahertz. So bandwidth into length kaapatti pulse broadening bandwidth length product kaapatti. So we can obtain that bt into l. So 5.25 megahertz into 5. So 26.25 megahertz is the bandwidth length product for the fiber. That is the simplest questions also be asked. And last but one, on commonly available single mode fibers. Bit lengths, we have already discussed the bit lengths in the range of 10 centimeters so to 2 meters. What is the range of refractive index difference? Does the corresponding lambda is equal to 13 nanometers? Okay, bit lengths will be given. LB is equal to 10 centimeters to 2 meters, operating wavelength 1300 nanoseconds nanometers, and bit length is equal to LB is equal to 2 pi by beta x minus beta y. That is the formula. So beta x minus beta y is equal to k k into nx minus ny. So we can substitute that value. Lb is equal to 2 pi by k into nx minus ny. So here k is equal to 2 pi by lambda, and Lb will be reduced as Lb is equal to lambda by nx minus ny. So if you consider the Lb is equal to 10 centimeters, then the difference is considered as nx minus ny is equal to 13 into 10 power minus 6. If you consider Lb is equal to 2 meters, nx minus nb is equal to 650 into 10 power minus 9. So the refracted differences nx minus ny will be the range between 650 into 10 power minus 9 to 13 into 10 power minus 6. So manaki beat lengths anedi isthe, then automatically then oka differences anedi manam teesukunetappudu refractive indexes anedi ee formula use chesukoni ekkuva use chestam. Lb is equal to 2 pi by beta x minus beta y. So manaki ikkada representations anedi ee formula use chesukoni manam identify chestam. You want to calculate the waveguide dispersion in units. Waveguide dispersion anedi ippudu raledu. Waveguide dispersion in units of PS per kilometer for a 9 by 125 single mode fiber with n1 is equal to 1.48, d is equal, dispersion is equal to 0.22%, operating at wavelength 1.3 micrometers. Core diameter is equal to 9 micrometers. Cladding diameter is equal to 125 micrometers. So they given the n1 and delta and lambda and diameter d. Okay. So normalized frequency number v number, we already know that v is equal to 2 pi by a by lambda into na. Okay. So v is equal to, we already know the 2 pi lambda value and a value and numerical aperture. Numerical aperture means you can write na is equal to n1 into 2 delta. N1 value you know and delta value you already know. So you can substitute that values. You can obtain the normalized frequency v is equal to 2.13. You can obtain the normalized frequency 2.13. On relative refractive index, delta nearly is equal to n1 minus n2 by n1. So you can substitute that value. N2 is equal to 1.476. You can obtain the n2 is equal to 1.476. So we already know the waveguide dispersion is given by, so it is for a single mode fiber. So dispersion is equal to n2 delta minus n2 delta by c into 1 by lambda into v into d square vb by dv square. So for a waveguide, it derivatives that vb by dv is plotted in the function of v number. So manam v number lo ikkada functionality anedi representation iskunte ee vidhanga untundi with respect to of v number. Okay. Then you can substitute that values. So v is equal to 2.13 is 0.58. So you can substitute that values. Then finally we can obtain that d waveguide is equal to, all the values will be substituted, then we can obtain that 0 minus 0.102 ps for nme. So waveguide dispersion for that particular representation is considered as -0.102 ps for nanometers kilometers. Okay, this is the representation. Here you can identify the some value related to the v number, related to the v number. So like this the waveguide dispersion formulas will be also be asked. Okay. Hello, problems anni compulsory ga 1 2 3 units lo third unit koncham takkuva compulsory ga B bit అనేది ప్రాబ్లం వస్తుంది అందుకనే ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ మళ్ళీ చెప్తున్నాను ఓకేనా సెకండ్ యూనిట్ లో కూడా ఏదైనా డౌట్స్ ఉంటే డిఫరెంట్ మోడల్స్ అనేది ఈ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ మీద అడుగుతారు ఓకేనా రేపు ఫోర్త్ యూనిట్ స్టార్ట్ చేస్తాను ఓకేనా ఎవరు మిస్ అవ్వమాకండి ఫోర్త్ యూనిట్లోకి వచ్చేసరికి మనకి మీరు ఆల్రెడీ బ్లాక్ డయాగ్రామ్లో చూసే ఉంటారు మనకున్నది ఏంది ఆప్టికల్ సోర్సు ఆప్టికల్ ఫైబరు ఆప్టికల్ డిటెక్టరు తర్వాత మనకి రికవరీ సిగ్నల్ అనేది ఉంటుంది యూజర్ అనేది సో మనకి ఫోర్త్ యూనిట్ వచ్చేసరికి ఏంటంటే ఆప్టికల్ సోర్సెస్ ఎల్ఈడి లేజర్ ఎల్ఈడిలో టూ టైప్స్ ఉంటాయి లేజర్స్లో టూ టైప్స్ ఉంటాయి ఎల్ఈడిలోకి వచ్చేసరికి వాట్ ఆర్ ద క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ దట్ విల్ బి సపోర్టెడ్ ఫర్ డిఫరెంట్ పారామీటర్స్ ఓకే అవి తీస్తాం అలానే లేజర్లో కూడా వాట్ ఆర్ ద క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ ఆఫ్ ది పారామీటర్స్ దట్ విల్ బి సపోర్టెడ్ ఫర్ లేజర్ ఓకే బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దట్ ఓన్లీ ద పర్ఫార్మెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది లేజర్ అండ్ పర్ఫార్మెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎల్ఈడి విల్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్ ఓకేనా ఫోర్త్ యూనిట్ అనేది మొత్తం ఆప్టికల్ సోర్స్ సంబంధించి ఉంటుంది ఫిఫ్త్ యూనిట్ అనేది ఆప్టికల్ రిసీవర్ అండ్ డిటెక్టర్ రెండింటి గురించి ఉంటుంది ఓన్లీ ఫోర్త్ యూనిట్ ఓన్లీ డిటెక్టర్స్ సారీ ఆప్టికల్ సోర్సెస్ గురించి ఉంటుంది ఫిఫ్త్ యూనిట్ వచ్చేసరికి ఏంటంటే ఆప్టికల్ డిటెక్టర్స్తో పాటు ఆప్టికల్ రిసీవర్స్ కూడా జాయిన్ అయి ఉంటుంది సో మీకు కొంచెం లెంతీ యూనిట్స్ రెండు రేపు ఫోర్త్ యూనిట్ స్టార్ట్ చేస్తాను ఎవరు మిస్ అవ్వమాకండి ఓన్లీ 40 నెంబర్స్ వస్తున్నారు వచ్చినా కొంతమంది వెళ్ళిపోతున్నారు వచ్చినా కొంతమంది లీవ్ అవుతున్నారు అలా చెప్పండి లీవ్ అవుతుందని చెప్పండి మరొగా అలానే అందరూ అటెంప్ట్ అవ్వాల్సిందిగా చెప్తున్నాను మళ్ళీ రేపు వద్దున అటెండెన్స్ మళ్ళీ ఆప్తే మాత్రం ఏం చేసేది లేదు అర్థమవుతుంది అందరికి హలో
సార్